Hey everyone, how's it going? In this video, let's have a look at the Pixys OS ROM for the LG V30. As you can see here, this is the 2.4 version and this is the 3rd May 2019 build. And as you can see here, there is some other info available as well in the about section. Now let's move on. You have some customization for buttons. As you can see here, you even have the clear all location written here. You have the navigation bar buttons, power menu customization, and notification like traffic indicators, status bar items, lock screen shortcuts, battery charging light. Now you will also find some gestures available here, so that's pretty cool. You have the option of digital well-being. Make sure that you use appropriate G apps so that you get the option of digital well-being. I think you need at least micro G apps for it to be enabled. Under here you even have the option of hi-fi cord DAC when you turn in your earphones to the headphone jack. Moving on to the display section, you have some customization options here as well. You have ambient display. It works decently, but there is one bug. If you turn on the always on display option, it only works when you get a notification. See, I've turned on the always on display and I press the power button. The always on display will not come on instantly, but let's say I get a message on WhatsApp and then the always on display will turn on and stay turned on. So that's kind of a bug right now. You have other stuff like lock screen charging info, status bar, accidental touch, recent UI. As you can see here, you can change this up here. Tap to wake. You even have different styles. Let me switch to black UI. So as you can see here, let's see if we have any other different options. So dark UI will be similar, but it won't be black to say. You have QS style, you have the option of fonts. And other than this, I haven't really found any other bugs, except that you have to manually set the APNs in your network settings. This is some kind of bug that will probably be sorted out by the next build. Performance is pretty smooth here, gaming is good, and battery life also seems on par with other custom ROMs. So that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.